So last week I showed you my version of what could be an Apple product video or commercial, and today I'm going to show you how I edited that video in DaVinci Resolve 18. And it's actually a surprisingly simple edit, but maybe let's watch it again first as a quick refresher. And if you want to know how I shot that video here at my desk, I'll link the behind the scenes video down below in the description. Okay, but now the edit. And look, I'm not gonna explain everything in detail. I'm gonna walk you through my timeline, show you what I did, but if I talk about speed ramps, for example, and you don't know how speed ramps work in DaVinci Resolve 18, then you're gonna have to look for a tutorial yourself. I'm not gonna explain all that because it would make this video way, way too long. And then one more thing before we start, I really have to thank ArtGrid and Artlist because they supplied me with all the stock footage and music and sound effects that I needed to make that commercial. But more on that later. Now, let me show you the timeline because that's what you're here for. And first, let me give you an overview of the timeline. So the top track here, the pink one, consists of adjustment clips containing the color grade, which is basically just one of my LUTs that I tweaked a bit depending on the clip, because, you know, for some shots the lighting was slightly different and then the colors didn't match exactly. But that's it, nothing else, just color grade. This is the main track containing all the video clips, so this is where most of the visual editing happens, and these yellow clips here are fusion clips. What that means is, they're basically the original clip, or part of a clip, but converted into a fusion clip, so that I could add visual effects to it in Fusion. And I've created these fusion clips just for the text effect, but I'm not gonna explain how I did that text effect because I already did that in another video, and I'll link that video in the description. Then these green clips are the music, and there's actually something very interesting going on here. So this is the start of the song, but here where the camera goes up, I wanted some kind of pause or break in the music. But of course the song doesn't pause at exactly the same moment when the camera goes up. So what I did is, I cut the song here, I stopped it, fade to nothing, and this clip here is actually a break or pause in the music that happens somewhere near the end of the track. So I cut it out and pasted it here. In a way, I kinda rewrote the song to force that break here when the camera goes up. And then here I've used a part of the song where it's at its peak. So, you know, always remember that you can cut and edit music so that it matches better with what's happening in your video. And these purple clips here are some sound effects for the text effects and some whooshes for the transitions. And like I said, I got the music and the sound effects from Artlist. And I know that there's a bunch of platforms where you can get music, but I don't know, for these kind of projects, I always find myself going back to Artlist, because I feel like that's where I can find music that sounds a bit different. There's a link down below if you want to find out more, but highly recommended if you're into these commercial kind of projects. Now, if I get rid of the fusion clips and the color grade, you see, there's not much going on. It's a very simple edit. All visual editing, except for the text effect, happens on the main track. So let's go over the main track now, because, you know, that's where all the magic happens. And most of that magic happens in the first shot, but it's not too difficult, it's mostly just tedious work. Manually keyframing everything and speed ramping. So let me show you what the original shot looks like, without keyframes and speed ramps. This was shot in 50 frames per second slow motion, by the way. And you can see that the image is not centered and also not leveled, and the timing is also off. And, you know, I wanted a nice, smooth crane movement up that flowed with the music. And the easiest way to do that is by keyframing everything and using speed ramps. So let me show you the keyframes first. All these white dots here are keyframes. Yeah, that's a lot of them. And pay attention to the inspector window here. You can see that for every keyframe, the position and size of the clip changes, and even the rotation, pitch and yaw. So what all those keyframes are doing is simply keeping the Apple logo centered and the image leveled. And it's simply a matter of adding a keyframe when you see that it looks off, then center and level the image, move a few frames forward and do the same. Every time the logo or the Mac Studio is off center or when the image doesn't look leveled, adjust it. And then the speed ramps. Here at the beginning, the speed is 100%. But then here, when the camera starts moving up, that's where I added speed ramps. It gradually speeds up. And the speed curve here looks like this. And then at the end, when the camera goes down, also a speed ramp. And these speed ramps, you know, they allow you to control the speed so that you get a nice, smooth movement that flows with the music. And what I also did to make it look like the camera goes faster than it actually does, while the camera moves down, I also zoom in on the logo digitally. And then it really looks like the camera is diving into the logo. And then we have a simple zoom transition to the next clip. It's a built-in transition, nothing fancy. Just go here to effects, video transitions, and that's where you'll find it. And this is, of course, a stock footage clip. I got this clip from ArtGrid, Artlist's sister or brother. And look, there's a ton of cool clips of computer chips and circuit boards available. But let me give you a tip. When you're looking for a stock footage clip for a video like mine, which has these zoom in and out transitions, you have to make sure that the camera movements of the stock footage clip are not completely opposite to your shots, because then you won't be able to make a smooth transition. The clip that I've used for my video is reversed actually, but by reversing that clip, the camera movements matched up almost perfectly. Okay, and then here, when it looks like we're jumping out of the Mac Studio, that's a zoom out transition, similar to what I did in the opening shot. And again, a lot of keyframes and speed ramping, but nothing crazy. And that's it actually. The rest of the video is just hard cuts and music and sound. Here I lowered the music so you can hear the fan. You can't actually hear the fan in real life, but you know, I think it sounds cool and I don't know, it sounds cool. And of course, there's more text effects. Just check out the link in the description if you want to give this text effect a try. And that's it basically. A very, very simple edit. Just a lot of keyframing and yeah, tedious work. And you know, you could try doing this in another way. For example, by locking the position of the Apple logo and then stabilizing the footage. That might work too, but I'm not an expert in fusion and visual effects, so I like to do it manually. If it works, it works, right? Thank you so much for watching, guys. I hope you liked it and see you in the next one.